going on, everyone? Welcome to the Rabbit My YouTube channel. And today I'm going to be showing you guys how you can swap your BSC BEP20, which is the Binance Smart Chain Flux, into mainnet Flux in your Zelcore wallet. All right, so your first question may be, why do I have Binance Chain Flux and not mainnet Flux? Aren't you mining Flux? No, I am not mining Flux with the GPUs I have. Ethereum is the most profitable coin to mine, so that's what I have been mining. But I do use the crypto.com app. It only supports the Binance Chain Flux. So I did swap some Ethereum into Flux. I originally wanted to run a Cumulus node. I do not have the bandwidth on my internet to do so, and it's not worth it at this point in time to rent a VPS, as the crypto bear market makes up prices. I will lose money, you know, overall. So I did swap some ETH over. I got my Binance Chain Flux. I moved it over to my Zelcore wallet, and now I got to get this set to mainnet Flux so I can utilize one of the new Titan nodes. So that's what I'm going to be showing you guys here. So step number one in this whole operation is you're going to need all your addresses kind of set out here. You're also going to need some BNB, some BEP20. So if you don't have any BNB, you know, you could buy some from Binance, obviously, or any, most exchanges have it now. You may have some hanging out in your MetaMask. Just send that over to Zelcore and you're all set. You shouldn't need too much. I only got about $7 worth here. Hopefully this is enough. And we're going to have to go into our apps. Once we're in our apps, we're going to select Fusion. And then we're going to have to pick the wallet we actually want. If I just use payments here, we just go into here. I'm going to use Flux. You can see I only have 8 Flux because it's reading the wrong wallet. All the stuff I was showing you in the previous screen is all in my income. And now you can see I have 0 Flux, which is what I had in that wallet. But I am going to have to pick BSC Flux here. This will utilize this. So max, now you can see it's reading on my BSC Flux. Now I want to swap this into Flux. Again, I'm just going to make sure it's all there. You can see the swap rate here. So this is going to charge me 4 Flux as a fee and 0.000378 BNB. I have all that. We saw that in the wallet. So I am going to get $522 USD from 524. So we're losing like $2 here. That's okay. I need this mainnet Flux anyway. So simply, once you have everything lined up, all you got to do is hit this swap button. So here I go. It's going to say, yes, swap this for that. Yes, I want to swap that. Now it's going to take some time. I'm going to set a timer and see how long this actually takes. So Fusion swap in progress. 1024.85 Flux BSC to 1020.85 Flux July 23rd, 2022 at 2100. Status is new. So it's going to have to do its thing on the blockchain, go through the confirmations, and then once it's accepted, it's all good to go. So we will come back once all the confirmations are done. We can see we already got 3. Okay, so from the point in time when I did cut there, when I was finishing talking up, to the status of finished right now, it took 32.08 seconds. Let's just have a quick look to see if we actually have our Flux in our wallet. So I'm gonna go to portfolio and we're gonna go show a 0. And we're still waiting for it to do its thing, but you can see my Binance Flux is at 0. So it is gone and it is moving into this one. So now we have to wait a little bit of time here. I'm resetting my timer now. We're gonna start it and I will come back once the Flux is actually found within my wallet. Don't come to this part and start freaking out. This is 100% normal, trust me. Okay, so now we can see I do have my $523 worth of USD. 1020.85 Flux is now in my wallet. This took an additional 2 minutes and 13 seconds. So add 30 seconds onto this. So about 2 minutes and 33 seconds from the time I hit swap to have your actual Flux swapped over and into the wallet itself. So remember, if you click on that and you see all your funds are gone, you're like, oh, where to go? Don't worry, it is 100% okay as long as you use the proper addresses when you're doing the swaps. Okay guys, so it is that simple to swap your Binance Flux into mainnet Flux. You do lose a little bit, but not that much, and it's fairly fast. So a few key points to remember here, you're gonna need a little bit of BNB, as you can see, we hardly used any at all to send in order to swap over this a little over 1,000 Flux. And one thing you do got to remember when you are sending Flux to this wallet, make sure you are sending the proper Flux. Now, depending on the platform you're sending from, it may say there's an error or something, but but other platforms may not. And if you send it to the improper wallet address, you have the chance to lose your Flux. So always make sure you are sending to the proper chain. This one is the Binance BEP20, as you can see. But just for an example, if I was to go to manage assets, add an asset, look at the different variations here. Here we got your Flux TRX. So this is like your TRC20, that's your Tron network. Here's your Solana Flux. Here's your Cadena Flux, KDA, your Ethereum Flux, and then your AVAX type of Flux here. So there's a bunch of different chains of Flux that you could potentially have. So make sure you are sending to the proper wallet. And this goes for any crypto in general that has multi-chain networks, Matic, everything, all that stuff on it. Make sure you're always sending on the proper chain, or you do risk the chance of losing your crypto. So always keep that in mind. Always double and triple check your addresses. Maybe test with a small amount first if you are unsure, but that is way better off spending a little bit of fees instead of sending a whole lump sum and losing all your crypto. So hopefully this helps you out in switching any type of coin, most likely here, the Binance Flux into mainnet Flux. I'll see you on the next one. Rabbit out.